an early power play.
It's a power ball power play, and the Canes get it back to Burns. Now it's Aho. Right to Nason out in front, and Kemper has to make the save. Aho will ring it around for Svechnikov, trying to set up something out front. Nason, Burns, he'll get it over to Natchez. Back for Burns. He'll wrist one, they'll score! Stefan Nason's first as a Cane on the power play. It's 1-0 Carolina.
Nason, beautiful redirection. He had to move his feet, initially made his stick a target from Natchez, and then gets himself back in a tipping position. Just enough separation from Ferrari to redirect it on the short side. Oh, what a beautiful look at the tip. Off the post. And
Caps power play with all the injuries they have coming into tonight will be Alexander Ovechkin, who's waiting to get to his office. But the Canes come up with a steal. Aho's got a step in on Kemper. Backhand save made by Kemper. Carolina's up 1-0. Sebastian Aho had a great shorthanded opportunity, but Kemper with the glove. Oh, Hannah, great stuff. And it's something that Hannah chronicled in the first period as well. The maturity, not physically, but mentally, that's part of this game as the second period's underway. And as Ferrari jumped in from his defensive position. And Jensen will wrist one. Anderson gets the stick to it. Then it's freed out, and Strom pops it home. Anderson couldn't control the rebound. Strom got loose out front. And Dylan Strome, second of the year, ties this one a minute 23 into the second period.
Well, I thought Malenstein, wearing 47, initially created a good chance. Then Washington had puck retrieval. Anderson must have had trouble seeing it on the way in to not absorb that puck. So Strome's screen creates his own rebound, but then in one motion, he rotates and wins. Zero hesitation. Shane Willis talked about stacking up at your own blue line during one of the kills in the first period. Happened again there.
Well, Carolina trying to clear, but it's Kepteen Gustafson. Sends it across. Ovechkin scores on the power play. His 785th career goal. 399th on the road. And Alexander Ovechkin on the power play.
Really only a shot that Ovechkin can pull off. I mean, well outside the dots. Stepan had a decision to make. He could have shadowed Ovechkin to a degree.
With a tight turn, he'll find Svechnikov. He'll drop it back. Natchez into the Washington zone. Natchez has a lane shot out in front. They'll score on the rebound. Andrei Svechnikov, number 8 for 37, and the Canes have tied it at 2.
Period. The Hurricanes have successfully gotten to the front of the net. And an activating defenseman. Net front, beautifully sold from Stastny. He gets a piece of it. Activating defense in Chatfield. And Andrei Svechnikov as a gaping.
The unbelievable balance of Brent Burns jumps out to me, Mike.
Oh, that was Alexander Ovechkin in the penalty box. Great stuff, Shane, at ice level. 20 seconds left now as the period's underway. And
if you do that, the Hurricanes have the more talented roster tonight.
And now Natchez, he speeds into the Washington zone. Rap chance, Kemper gets a pad to it. Kotkaniemi tries to get a stick to it. No Carl Hagelin, no Nick Backstrom, no Tom Wilson, no John Carlson tonight.
I tell you, he just about pulled it off. Ferrari missed trying to go stick on puck.
Scored on their last power play, Ovechkin. This is fifth of the season, as now it's set up, and Slavin makes a huge save as Anderson was out of the net. Jacob Slavin with a monstrous block here on Halloween. And then it's Jacob Slavin. No candy for you, Kuznetsov. We're tied at 2 in the third. And that hit the heel of his stick as he was trying a one-timer.
Heck of a back check from Sherry. Good news, Nason for now is still on the bench.
And now a big save by Mr. Anderson. Oh, Frederik Anderson Another opportunity. Ovechkin trying to come through. Loose puck. Anderson again makes the save. Shutting the door here in the third period. Here's Strom. Because my thing is, if it's a trip, it's a trip. If you embellish it, it wasn't a trip. Either way, it's 4-on-4 hockey as the Canes get it right up for Pesci and Kemper with his biggest save of the period.
Gets on the inside of Jensen. Quick release. You can see the flex of his stick.
Now Ovechkin showing a little bit of speed. He'll get the puck right back. Ovechkin tries to dance around Pesci. Puck will roll in on Anderson, who had to be ready. 24-17, a shorthanded Capitals team. The amount of players that they're on. Now Martinuk behind the net. Centering chance for Faust. Rebounds available. Martinuk puts it on. In the period, win probability. Carolina's at 55%. They'd love to make it 100 right now. Stastny with it. Out front for Kotkaniemi. Kemper makes the save on the deflection.
All the chances you look for. This unit gets on the ice off of the initial entry.
Comes Kotkaniemi. He's got to walk across the blue line. He'll get it in. Teravainen sends it in deep. 15 seconds left in the period. Pucks available. Heavy hit behind the net that involved Kotkaniemi. Now he's looking up front. Quick shot on Kemper, the side of the net.
So you might be able to generate something here right away if you win the draw.
Now the draw is won by Carolina, but Johansson will come out of the box now. Svechnikov with it for Carolina. 7 seconds left in overtime. That puck's knocked away. 4 seconds left, 3 seconds left, and we are heading to a shootout. In the shootout. He ended the Philadelphia game in overtime. Let's see if he can get the shootout going for the Canes. He comes in and scores!
Halloween high heat. He knew exactly what he was doing when he stepped off the bench. It was just about execution. Pounds it home.
And he is taking the slow play approach here. Ambling in on Anderson. Waiting. Scores.
I mean, this is the slowest I've ever seen. And eventually...
Here comes Andrei Svechnikov, 6-for-12 in his career in the shootout. And he's going wide, now comes in on Kemper. The forehand, it scores! A nifty snapshot.
Back in the inception of the shootout, it was Hurricanes like Matt Cullen, Jussi Jokinen, halfway up on the blocker side. Beautifully executed by Svechnikov.
37-for-114 in his career on the shootout, coming in on Frederik Andersen. Ovechkin stopped by Anderson. Anderson got the glove up as Ovechkin tried to elevate.
That's off, but he's able to get out, match the speed, and challenge. Beautiful layers on the glove.
And he end October here with a shootout goal. 1-for-4 in his career. Natchez coming down with speed in on Kemper, and Kemper closes the door.
Trying to open the goaltender up. So now, can you go 6-2-1 in October? Strome versus Anderson.
In the shootouts in his career. Coming in on Frederik Andersen, it's Dylan Strome. And Anderson closes the door. Mr. Anderson with the saves when they needed him. Gives Carolina a 3-2 shootout win.
Late regulation, and then in overtime. Good stuff. Freddy brings the arms in, so it saves on Ovechkin, and then Strome. Burns and Svechnikov get it done.